shine. This my time, my life. 24/7 I grind. I'm feeling alive. I got no plans to die. Shine. This my time, my life. Married to the game, my wife. Life.
Facilita. Swansky bots our entanglement again, Gaston. Get an arga translate.
Entanglement.
I agree with the pizza.
Come on, entanglement, the direct translation. I agree. Tangle, hobore, ratum. Like, yeah,
whatever that is.
I'm not gonna tell you her surname yet, Wawa, because her surname is entanglement.
I see.
So I go, I ask, oh my god, hey, why would you do that to your ex? Hey, what's on a entanglement? I get it. Hey, 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 according to a certain lady, that's my friend in Facebook, says
entanglement
ke kholagano ka Setswana.
Kholagano sounds more like kholego, like imprisonment of some sort.
Hey, why kholega here?
Hey, kholegile.
Hey, kholegile ka entanglement.
Yes.
Anyway, back to past us now.
Probably 18 out there wondering what is your life going to sum up to entanglements. Here's a few things that I wish somebody would have told me when I was 18.
Yeah, 18. You're gonna catch a lot of L's. You need to find your purpose. Do you know what you wanted to do when you're 18?
I'm about to turn 27. I still don't know what my purpose is. So I think it's a question that you're gonna probably ask yourself for the rest of your life. But don't get me wrong, you know, some people tend to find that purpose way sooner in life. Mm-hmm. We all know it's our race, you know, but
one thing we need to tell a lot of kids before they start going out into the real world, especially spoiled kids. When you spoiled, yeah, but even when you weren't spoiled, you still had to know how you gotta catch L's in life so that you keep on learning and keep it moving.
Well, maybe I was spoiled a little because, you know, I was raised by a single mom and not two hellas, so she provided, took care of me. It's an English medium, up until standard 7, you're like a form 1 out 10, a below retla games, a behot, no one I could born. I know a lot of people say education is not the key to success, so but you have to understand.
It can get you an advantage. It's not really key to success. Yeah,
you can gain a competitive advantage.
Because what Do you remember from high school?
Yeah, honestly, osmosis nyana halele halele motswara osmosis nyana. Like I said,
you're
the
apply, like that, up to now, I still remember simultaneous equations, but I still don't know what I need to use them for.
Like, and that's a question I know most of you are asking in class now, but it's just about the course you end up doing, right? And I know it's hard because I lead to a lot of the course beef, but engwe ya gona le mathematics ono u ithutang gona ane engwe le engwe ya gona le physics e u ithutang gona one will have the science, all the sciences, one will have the English, one will have the literature, one will have the history, one will have, you know,
hey, all the
one way or the other, a few of your subjects will play a huge role in your life going forward. Learn agriculture. I mean, why to Botswana
farming.
Right, Zama, and you know, thank God agriculture is one of the subjects in our curriculum because it actually, you know, now I'm looking back and I should have paid more attention to agriculture because now I want to be a farmer.
Now I want to start bees myself.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
So but I
don't know what in particular in farming, I just know I want to be a farmer.
Yeah. It's also now comes to the Kenya finding your purpose, like what do you really like doing, or compared to what you should be doing, compared to what can make you money fast, but what is really your purpose to the world?
That's a
million
pula question.
That's a million pula question when you turn 18 or even turn 27, right?
It never stops, guys.
I wish someone told me that when I was 18.
And sometimes, you know, the worst part is, you know, sometimes you think that you have a way or you have a dream that's gonna fuel all the success that you want in your life, but you have to also know that dreams change. It's not that when dreams change you're letting go of that particular thing. Sometimes you have to find another way to get at what you want to achieve in life. So
like the time you used to wish you were a superstar sports player,
if I'm being honest with you,
for those basketball,
but for those who really know me as Silas, they know that I love rap.
Oh, what's up, Dot?
Our producers in the back making noise. But yeah, anyway, anybody who truly knows me as Silas knows that I've identified as a rapper, and I still do identify as a rapper, you know. But as the more I age and the more I realize that it's actually a lot harder. Well, not now. I mean, it's 2020 and I've seen my fellow countrymen have opportunities that I wish I had. And I'm still going to be a rapper for the rest of my life, but my approach to theirs is always going to be different now, because I'm currently finding another way to fuel the passion. You know, because I can't let it stop. I still rap. But anyway, that's far from the point. That was just one thing about school, right? You guys need to understand that your degree isn't particularly going to determine what you do with the rest of your life, right?
I wish it did.
I really wish it did too, man. But you find yourself going through this whole 16-year path. Standard 1 to standard 7, form 1 to form 3, form 4 to form 5, then first year or fourth year if you're that lucky to get a degree, because that's like the bare minimum, I think, for getting a degree, right? By the time that is all over, you find that you've spent so much time acquiring knowledge, which is, yes, a good thing, but it's not paying you right here, right now. So the other person who dropped out of school or failed from 5 started a semausu arekisari nekere, and between the 7 years you were still going to school, he was accumulating wealth. By the time
and also knowledge to a certain extent.
To an extent. You know, that comes with a little bit of finance, accounting, budgeting. Those are skills.
Some literacy to
you have to have some financial literacy.
I mean, how do you keep the business running without some financial literacy?
You find that your homie has a dad who is a prominent farmer, and this guy is set for life. He's just going to school just because he was told that, oh yeah, no, tena skolo like that, but don't worry, we got you, you know. And it doesn't happen for everybody, but it happens to some people, you know, where you know that you don't have to worry about anything. And the best thing you can do is maybe complement that particular lifestyle with a certain degree, you know. Your family is already a prominent farming family.
You're gonna start farming.
And maybe I've never understood horse riding.
Comment. Is there a course called horse riding? I've never heard it. I thought it was a lie. Go ahead and lie.
Let me tell you why I know.
You know what? Pack your fish.
During that era where you're applying for schools and getting acceptance, accepted, wherever you're getting accepted.
Yeah.
I ended up hakijila madi aho apply go UB later. Wabon. Kirare hadi ya already ask.
Why does everybody have a UB story?
And no, that UB story. So I still went and played along with that day anyway. So gonna get the prospectors, gonna get those possible courses you can take. Oh, go ahead, long go for take a couple of pamphlet that thing. Horse riding and the ballet thing. Man, this was a long
horse riding.
I started varsity in what, 2013, man.
Please,
7 years ago.
I've heard those rumors, but I come on, really.
In other words, I point the hell out of them. But I tell you, we're in school 16 years of our life. We tell them to put themselves in an advantage. Sometimes don't underestimate the next person.
Yeah.
Whether it's 23 points, 45 points, the ultimate truth is that we're going to 23 points. You know, and it shouldn't take away from your own self-worth. Yeah. No one is defined by grades.
No one is defined by degrees. No one is actually even defined by money either.
You know,
you need to find your sense of purpose and what makes you happy. What makes you wake up in the morning?
Which brings me to relationships.
Ish.
Entanglement.
Entanglement.
Some of you have had the joy or the pleasure of love. If you are anything like me, I'm a lover of love. It's something I confess to anybody who will listen.
Rato is a beautiful thing. So much is afraid of rejection.
The worst part right now is imagining losing her after all the effort that we put into the relationship.
Yeah.
You know? But here we are again. How many relationships have you been in since you started dating up to today? And I'm not talking about entanglements. I'm talking about
camera relationships. You know?
I'm talking about actual relationships.
Someone
that you fell for.
Okay. Current girlfriend.
Yes.
Current girlfriend.
And we're going backwards.
Let's go backwards.
Okay.
Current girlfriend. Yes. Hi, baby. Hey, how about we welcome my name?
Elias.
Missed birthday.
Aha! Hey, it's a joke for you guys. Miss birthday number one.
Miss birthday. 2.5 years. No, that one was a fling.
Entanglement.
Entanglement. Entanglement off. Okay. The one I remember when after high school, I was like, I guess it's a guy who hits a high. It's a really guy who hits a form five. He had a mock exam. He said, Even now, okay. The single, and then one had entanglement. Until 2.5 years.
So what for?
So four relationships.
Can there be someone before?
No.
Okay.
Come on, yes.
So four. Same question to me. I would roughly say five with me. I don't want to include the fifth one because it was my first heartbreak. And you know how Drake says the first love is the sweetest, but the first cut is the deepest. That's how it
feels.
So you can imagine what it's like, you know, having to experience a heartbreak for the first time. It creates so much negativity around each gender, or each species. It can only be this gender, or Lord, fetch your children, or your sons are doing this. Kore, it's either men ain't shit, or girls are this. We name each other. Ultimately, look, I think
trash.
I think the honest truth is that we hurt each other.
Yeah, you know, everywhere. Yeah.
Sometimes I get my first deep cut, and to try and fill up the void, I go do something stupid and unequivocally or unintentionally rather end up hurting someone else. And I become the villain in that story. And then men are trash.
Yeah.
You know, but that girl broke me first.
So
I think that's one thing we need to learn how to navigate is that my little brother is 16 now, he's got his first girlfriend and it's sweet, he's in love. But I fear for him because he doesn't my other brother is probably the most handsome of us all. I think last bonds are whoever's watching the video, whether you're a girl or you're a guy, right? You know that look, some guy's probably gonna break your heart. or some girl is probably gonna break your heart. And it's just a cycle of life.
Yeah.
It happens. Mm. But we grow, we live, we learn. And right now, I'm applying all of these lessons I've learned in my past relationships to the current one. But I'm not trying to let you know what I'm saying?
Let me repeat my yeah. Like
you don't want to let your past influence
the
things that you do to today. But you
English is offline.
English is offline. Relationship dia like that. Relationship. Plain and simple, right? Yeah. Or sansuto ten work stress. Or sansuto jola or sansuto rata. Ragama blom on tonaga, buy her those flowers, do the right thing. Just
don't overdo it though.
Yeah. But all I'm saying is I want us to come to a point where we learn how to navigate through these things, right? So that we stop labeling each other as if either person is setting up the next person to fail or something like that.
Yeah, right?
Relationship. These days, because of Facebook, now it's a video and it's a girl who wants a straight or entanglement. Entanglement.
The logo of the year.
Of the year. Hey. Of the year.
So that means 2020 means entanglement. As much as they say, death is the destination of life. Whoa.
So,
life you are going to live.
Yeah.
And you must keep on keeping on because somewhere, somehow, you need to find your purpose.
Yeah, don't wake up 27 one day and I mean you can still have a question of what my purpose is, but at least have some sort of idea of the answers you want, or a particular, even if you're shaping the own path for yourself by starting a business or working for a company. I know some of us
even going back to school again.
Oh yeah, or even going back to school.
Getting
again,
a master's, PhD, master's
or different or different course altogether.
Yeah.
That's on you. But do something in the effort of bettering your own life as opposed to just sitting there and hoping that somebody's going to save you. Nobody is going to save you, man. Nigga, nobody. Nobody's
nobody.
Going to save you.
Nobody's yeah, going to save, save you.
The only person you can bank on is yourself.
You. No. Yes, and no. This one, I actually wish they told me when I was 18.
Sure. What is
love
it?
Yourself.
Yeah.
Self that love is the
that
best
is important.
Love. Self
yeah.
love is the best love. I really yeah. wish yeah. I took myself, yeah. you know, loved myself more when I was younger.
I
wish I had sharpened more fresh haircuts. You know.
Kept it consistent. Shoe shining.
You know, shoe shines. You know.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
presentation counts. You know, sometimes
yeah,
first impressions.
It does.
Because of self-love.
Yeah, a friend of mine in Toastmasters said sometimes you have to dress the way you want to be addressed. And it's something that...
I remember that.
It's something that has stuck with me since, you know. Right now, I'm just doing content, so, you know, well, okay, in hoodies or leather jackets. But, you know, when you get into corporate offices, you know, there's a standard
that
you have to follow. It's an unwritten law. I mean, no one is forced
to come looking smart, but we all gotta do it, that we look serious.
So, yeah.
Our stuff.
But if there's anything else that you would like to know that you wish somebody would have told you when you're 18, you can always comment on the section, on the comment section below so that we can create the next video for you, so that we can talk more about all these other broad aspects of life. Because life, you will say, period, from school, finding your purpose, relationships, and death itself, you know, because we lose people almost every day, you know. Car crashes, Renoir Tata.
Yeah,
you know,
deadly
and diseases,
friends, and
unfair.
Even like growing up with friends that you thought you'd grow old
with.
Everything. Yeah, like,
it's almost as if, for this video,
Silas has said a lot. Guys, please feel free to follow him there.
We're together in his channel, okay?
Right, thank you so much for watching this video. Please feel free to smash that like button. button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and share it to the other social medias.
And give us the proper translation of entanglement.
Yes, we also need that as well.
Don't forget that part.
To follow us outside of YouTube, it's Silas Babs at Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Me, Mr. Beatbox, at Mr. Beatbox on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Until next time, shop, shop.